Hello guys, and welcome to episode 34 of my Total War Warhammer playthrough, playing as the Greenskins on very hard difficulty. And today we are going to be continuing attacking the Empire with the Siege of Nome. We're just waiting probably one more turn, and then I'm going to be attacking Nome. That should be something to look forward to. Then we have Wurzag replenishing his forces. Then he's going to be able to do his quest battle, so we'll get that done today as well. And then we're waiting for Grimgor to recruit his new forces so he can travel north with Morglus. However, we have just bumped into Eric Henrinson, and it looks like we might have to deal with him. He does have 4 units of Chaos Chariots, which is really, really irritating. Tempted to just bypass them completely though and just travel up north and take the dwarf holds. I'm not sure. It really depends. Like, the garrison at Kelek Kadrin is very strong now. This has Black Orcs, we got Night Goblin Archers, we got Orc Boar Boy Biggins. Savage Orc Boar Boys and Orc Biggins. Forest Goblin Spider Rider Archers, some Trolls. In Kalakung Gor, garrison isn't as good, but we're soon going to be building the ditches there, which will provide us with extra garrison and extra strong walls, so that will be good. Over at Zufbar, again, we got a very nice sort of garrison going on over here, so hopefully we won't get hit too hard by Varg. And maybe we'll have Varag Squigbeard head north with his Savage Orc army to help out up there. But that's all for this turn, so let's move on to the next one. See what happens. Oh, looks like Varg actually headed back up north. Three herds have come. Varag Squigbeard suffering from low feistiness, so we're going to quell animosity. Fine. We're going to build a couple more Savage Orc archers. Let's have like 6 of them. And we'll just continue Morglus north. We're not going to head south, so we can just ignore the ambush. Rugger can attack Nome this turn, so let's get on with this. We have 6 siege towers. Should be perfectly enough to make this work. Let's quick save it and fight it on the battle map. And here we are with our siege towers. Nice shoddily made siege towers. The lovely style of the orcs. Right, how are we going to do this? Let's see. We'll probably go from right to left. So we'll have the black orcs all go on the right side there. We'll have the orc archers not start in there. We'll have the 8 peak loonies go in. Actually, let's have the warlords boys go in one of them. We'll have these 3 go like so. Maybe even worth having Krugger on the walls, but he's actually got a mount, hasn't he? So we can't do that. Let's get the Arachnorok Spiders to charge down the gate with Krugger. Great stuff. Okay, so the rest of the units, the Nasty Skulkers, can sit back here. And we'll have the archers ready to run on up. Have them spread out like so. The rest of the units need to be hidden. Can't hide the chariots, that's fine. We can hide the rest of the units though. Including these chaps. Okay, let's start the battle. Pause it. Have them all move to the walls. Okay, and we'll have the Arachnorok Spiders with Krugger hit the gate. Make sure that we have our ranged forces running up. Nice and spread out. There we go. Yeah, Krugger just charging down the gates. It's going to take the fire from the towers for us. But this tower is taking quite a lot of damage. As long as these Black Orc towers aren't, we should be okay. Because we want the Black Orcs to be fine, so they can all clump up on the right side wall here and then charge to the left side and just batter down anything that gets in the way. The Arachnorok spiders are going for the gate. Looks like one's getting stuck behind the siege tower. Be able to take that down that gate relatively quickly. Oh, that tower actually got destroyed. That's a shame. We're going to have the apic loonies climb up the wall there. And these chaps can just go help at the gate. Let's move these archer boys in front of that. Move those guys forwards. And here go the Black Orcs. I would not want to be these swordsmen right now, having loads of Black Orcs charge forwards. Would not be very fun at all. Okay, let's have some of our units move on forwards. Spiders are through the gates, so let's have them charge on in. Have Krugger move on. We can go for the extra melee attack. That's going to affect all of the units on the top of the walls as well. Go for Spite of the Bad Moon as well. And we'll have all of these units come on in. Okay, so the Black Orcs have done their jobs. Let's charge on towards the center of the wall there. We might have one unit come down and attack the crossbowmen. And one unit attack the halberdiers. And the other unit can attack the swordsmen in the center. And two spiders, two Arachnorok spiders, just breaking through the center here. With Krugger just on his little squig leading them. I love it. Looks awesome. Okay, we're crushing those swordsmen nicely. Have the riders there, the ranged cavalry, just stay back. Carrots can come on through. Same with the nasty skulkers. And we're going to have these chariots actually run on towards the handgunners. Right, so they are free. Going to run on through. Okay, we crushed the halberds and the crossbowmen there. Continue those two off the walls. And charge those down. These Black Orcs up here can continue to attack the halberds on the walls. Now we've got the nasty skulkers involved in this fight as well. They're acting wrong. Spider's just doing so much damage. Okay, and we've managed to get on top of these handgunners with the orc-bore chariots as well. Okay, let's get these two units of Black Orcs to line up on the ramp. We'll have the Arachnorok spiders come over here as well. And the nasty skulkers can just chase down units that are running away. Great stuff. The Black Orcs on the wall here, facing off against these halberds, taking a lot of damage. Probably quite a lot of friendly fire, honestly. So let's maybe stop these guys from firing. We'll have them take up the walls, and we'll get through our ranged cavalry. Right, the chariots have dealt with the handgunners nicely. Soon we're going to be dealing with the Empire Knights. That's absolutely fine by me. We can have the Arachnorok Spiders move up and attack the Empire Knights before we charge in with the Black Orcs. Because that way we don't get charged. So, for example, they just charged into the Arachnorok Spider, and now we can just engage them with the Black Orcs in standard melee, which is great. going to move up these Wolf Riders and so on. 8 Pete Loonies can come up and join us. Can have one of these spiders charge onto the Empire Knights. It doesn't look like we're going to have a chance. We'll just slam into the spin with shields then. These chariots can come into the back of the crossbowmen there. Over on this side, the nasty skulkers should be dealing with the spin with shields quite nicely. Great, let's get the apic loonies in here. Charge on forwards with all of our black orcs and so on. Need to get Krugger up here as well, actually. You can use wire again. Any other units we've left behind? May as well get them to come towards the center square. Although it is going to be victory very shortly, as we have just crushed their entire army. Brilliant. We will end the battle there for a decisive victory. 266 losses, and Nuln is ours. Well, not ours, we're just going to sack it and raise it. I'll probably just raise it, because it does have walls, and we don't necessarily need the cash right now. Will just allow me to move on as soon as possible to the next settlement. When they are settlements without walls, we can definitely like raise and then sack them. Like in this case, like if I don't raise it, then they'll just get a garrison back again and we'll have to do the assault all over again. Although 20,000 is a lot. we're gonna do it that way anyway. Okay, so with Krugger then, we're going to go with thick skin maxed out. Actually, let's just go for Guard Veteran maxed out. Get him! And we can't do anything, so we're just going to go into Raiden Camp. And we'll take that 20k, that's actually quite nice. Allows me to worry a lot less about troops and... actually allows me to finish upgrading a lot of the buildings in some of these settlements. So let's go into our provinces tab now. Allows me to upgrade the walls and stuff. A Karakazgal, what we can fill up with the last slot with. Any of these buildings actually give income? No, they don't. A Karakazgal may as well get a Shaman's Heart so that we can recruit some more shamans once that's upgraded. Upgrade Barakvar to a Greenskin Stronghold. That's something we can do. Don't need to build anything here just yet. At Peak Pass, is there something else we can build here? No, that's fine. At Rib Peaks, no, we don't need to upgrade that one just yet. Elbaraz. Might be worth getting the big walls there. Silver Road, we might upgrade, yeah, I'll upgrade Karak as Akarak. And I might upgrade Ekrund. So Zufbar will upgrade this first to get the big walls there. So that's maxed out. Great. The Wurzag next turn will be fully replenished more or less, and I will move him on. Azag can carry on round towards Tilia. We have Grutshod moving up towards the Empire. Nearly there. And Largug now can head up north towards the mountains to complete our quest. Yeah, let's have a look at our quests actually. We have Squiggly Beast, 4 Night Goblin units in Wurzag's army. We can maybe sort that out before the end of the campaign. Bonewood Staff Battle is ready and waiting, and the Goromadni Mountains is the one I was heading towards with the Goblin Big Boss there. So that's all of the quests we have. It's fine. Okay, let's end the turn, move on to the next one. So I'll siege Nuln again, and I might even just auto resolve it. We'll have to wait and see. We are going to have to attack the Wood Elves at some point because they have taken some of the dwarf holds that we need. Crooked the Nose Picker has unleashed a Wah. Ready for duty. Huglug Backbiter. The Huglug's ready. Huglug get wounded? Oh yeah, he must have. He was part of Krugger's army. Okay, well that's fine. Let's have Krugger attack Nolm again. And yeah, we're just going to auto-resolve it. Going to take a lot of damage. We do lose the Warlord's boys, but that's fine. So we'll just raise that. And we are going to re-recruit those chaps when we're in camp stance. Oh, we can't. Okay. Oh, never mind. We can set this Wah to attack probably Grunberg, or maybe even start to siege Altdorf. Not sure. We'll target someone far away. So we'll target like Arlhart, for example. The reason for that is so that if I actually spot any armies, we'll target the armies instead. Because I want to be like raising and sacking these minor settlements rather than just letting the Wah go and destroy them. So yeah, Wurzag's basically sorted out his army now. He's also leveled up. So I think what we're going to do is maybe get Savages maxed out and then Shooters. We can do the quest for the Bonewood Staff. But it does say that we aren't necessarily in favour of winning that with the current army that we have. However, I don't really see how we could get a better army than we already have. Oh well. Let's continue to move on. Azag. Move through the Wood Elves' territory. It's fine. Morglis is going to carry on north. Let's go. Towards the Dwarf Holds up there. Grutshod is going to continue towards Nolm. And Varag Squigbeard is waiting to be able to recruit some more Savage Orcs. We're going to upgrade to the Savage Orc Host. And then we will get Savage Orc Biggins. Might even have to get rid of these, actually. If we get rid of, like, say, four units of Savage Orcs. I know I only just recruited them, but we'll get rid of them. We'll make Savage Orc Biggins instead. Because at least the army then will actually be useful. Rather than having normal Savage Orcs. They are completely outdated now in the campaign. Alright, let's move out the settlement here. And we're going to do the Bonewood Staff quest. Entirely sure if we're going to be able to win this one. Says we won't be able to, but we're going to teleport to it anyway. Wow, that's a big reinforcing army. Are these Night Goblin Archers fanatics? Yes, they are. They don't have any artillery. So that means we can force the defense. And what's the terrain like? Because it's supposed to be like an ambush, isn't it? Yeah, well, we can force them towards us. And then maybe we can win that way. We also have the foot of Gork and stuff from Wurzag, so it might be alright. Let's quick save it and fight it on the battle map.
It'll burn just how I like my battlefields. Gork wants us to fight the humans here. Says if we do that and smack him about real good, then he'll power up my staff. So listen to your mate, Wurzag. I'm the prophet, and what I says goes. Let's get him!
There we have it. So I'm not entirely sure where the reinforcements are coming in from, but we should be able to dispatch the original army quite nicely. They have an Empire army at their max. Right, let's just put these guys nice and thin. Pretty much our entire army is just Black Orcs. Pretty good, actually. We'll keep them thin. We'll keep the Night Goblins nice and thin as well in terms of formation. And, well, those can all be grouped. And group locked. We'll keep Wurzak separate. Try not to forget him this time, though. I'm going to keep, well, two squads of spiders on either side. We'll keep the trolls in the center with our main army. And we are going to need to use the goblin rock lobbers. So we do have artillery. I'm not sure if that's going to force them towards me. Hopefully will. Because then we can just remain defensive. Could help us out. Although pushing towards them maybe seems like a good idea. I'm not entirely sure. They're not moving, so yeah, we're going to move towards them. I guess they might be waiting until we get our Goblin Rock Lobbers into range. But either way, no point hanging about. Get the spiders into the forest. These guys can hang out left. The Wurzag's moving up with the army. And yeah, soon we'll have the Goblin Rock Lobbers in range. And when we do, they're going to be forced to come towards us. As they are now. Okay, so let's just play it out normally. And we'll start to target the Spearmen with Shields there. And we'll start to target Spearmen with Shields on the left side. Alright, let's just line up the army properly. And we'll have Wurzag chill out on the left side. Spiders are hidden on the right. Kill their commanders to stop them reinforcing. How do I kill their commanders that easily? I've got all these chaps back here. Adelbert, Solander, Kurt Van Strahl, and Rupert. Ready to bring in reinforcements. I guess I could maybe hit them with the Goblin Rock Lobbers to do some damage, but the best thing I can do here is just run my army forwards and engage them as soon as possible. So I can crush the initial army. Have the Goblin Rock Lobbers actually move forwards after they fired a couple of volleys. You have the Vindictive Glare available. Get the Night Goblins to target the handgunners for us. The lot can attack the crossbowmen. Have the spiders moving out wide. Great stuff. Let's have the Goblin Rock Lobbers move forwards. Gonna go for the mass attack order now. Make sure that the Night Goblins continue their orders onto the handgunners. Oh, look at that charge. Brutal. I don't actually want to engage with him, so we're going to get my Spider Riders to attack their heroes, why not? Let me just demolish this initial army. We really have. Okay, let's move on round. We'll probably use Wurzag's special ability Effigy to do some damage to maybe one of the wizards. It's going to take him a while to get into range, though. Okay, so here comes some reinforcements. Blackfire Pass. Yeah, I'll target the wizard here with that. And we're going to break off these spiders, actually, to attack those as crossbowmen. All right, let's just make sure that we are routing the rest of these forces. Looks like I've got some Black Orcs into the flanks of these great swords, so that's fine. We'll have the Night Goblin fanatics take out those crossbowmen on the left. I'm going to have these two units actually target the missile specialists here. Maybe we can do a lot of damage to those. Meanwhile, the rest of these units here, they can move up. And we can have, obviously, Wurzag getting involved here. We can use a Vindictive Glare. Well, he actually missed that entirely, but there we go. As for the Goblin Rock Lobbers, well, they've actually got into position now. We're going to have them fire at the Missile Specialists as well. Crushed all those units on the far left there very nicely. Alright, yeah, let's charge into the crossbowmen. Have these Black Orcs take care of the swordsmen that have reinforced. We get like a foot of gork onto like all of these heroes. That'd be pretty crazy. The Empire commanders are in disarray. Their army is fallen apart. Good. Is that it? We done. Because those swordsmen just completely ran. We don't want those guys to get engaged. We're going to make these guys skirmish. We need to have these melee forces continue to run forwards. Because currently, my archers are being engaged when we stab Black Orcs nearby. We shouldn't let that happen. Okay, so there's Rupert engaging. Get these spiders to attack their leaders. I'm really like worried about getting my army like too spread out, because if they bring in like a massive amount of reinforcements at once, I won't be able to deal with it. Looks like that's actually victory though. There we go. We've just run them off the field. That was a lot easier than I expected it to be. I think because we ran over the initial army so quickly, it basically left them in such a bad position that they couldn't call in any of their reinforcements. Either way, we can just consolidate our army in case the second army comes in. And we'll have all of the Night Goblin archers line up. Have the trolls come over and help deal with Rupert. Have Wurzag dealing with him though. We can use the effigy onto him. Probably going to use the Gaze of Morph as well. And use the Vindictive Glare at the same time. Great. And we may as well use Fists of Gork on him. And here we go as well. That will give all of the trolls a high amount of attack. Take care of Rupert. Great stuff. Use Arcane Conduit. Probably just going to use the Gaze of Morph again. Speed things up. And he'll die soon enough, I'm sure. Just being smashed to pieces and knocked down constantly. Wurzag and his trolls just going at it. The enemy lord is dead. Fantastic. Close victory. Did we actually attack the second army? The cause of Aslan took 1,325 damage. Really? I mean, the kills on my units don't really reflect that, but whatever. That's fine by me. Quest complete. We'll eat the captives for the replenishment, and that's job done. Homewood staff is powered up and ready for Wurzag. That's going to give us extra magic item drop chance, minus miscast chance, extra melee attack, extra magic resistance, extra income from post-battle loot, and also the ability for extra melee attack and charge bonus. Triggers when casting a spell. Ooh. So that's job done there. We can probably leave Migdal Mongol Barak now, and I might even head Wurzag up north to deal with Varg. He can go for a jolly up there, and we're going to level him up, finish off savages. Unfortunately, guys, it has been my time, so a rather successful quest battle there. Much easier than I actually expected it to be, but I'm not going to complain. We'll leave it at that. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye.